Hi, in this video, we are going to see what is GST and what are all the various components involved in it. So let us see the necessary information briefly. So before we see the video, please subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get the further notification of my new uploads. Okay, see the first one. What is GST? See, the term GST refers to the goods and service tax is a term signifying a one tax and a one nation policy. So this particular term signifies one tax, that is the same tax plan is applicable for the entire nation. So it is a one tax plan and one nation policy. Before the introduction of GST, there were multiple taxes like service tax, central excise and state value added tax, that is VAT. Okay, now all these things are simply replaced by GST. Now we have only one tax policy, that is GST. It's a one tax policy and one nation policy. It is applicable for the entire nation. The entire India, the whole India following a same pattern of tax policy. So this is called as GST. Okay, who will pay the GST? The GST will be payable by the buyer, that is the end user. An end user that consumes any goods or services will pay the GST. So this tax will be payable by the buyer. Whoever buys or consumes any goods as well as services will pay the GST. The GST has three different components. These are the three components. The first one is CGST, second one SGST, the last one IGST. CGST refers to Central Goods and Service Tax. SGST refers to State Goods and Service Tax. And the last one, IGST, refers to Integrated Goods and Service Tax. These are the three components which comes under GST. Okay, the next important thing is, what determines which category of GST is applicable? That is very, very important. Before you apply the different type of GST, you should know, you should have a clear-cut idea about the transaction. Whether the particular transaction, that is the movements of goods and services between one state to another state or within the same state, that is very important. Based on that only, you can decide which tax is applicable, that is which GST is applicable. So let me explain along with an example. See, generally, the central GST and state GST is applicable for intrastate. Okay. And the last one is integrated GST. So this is applicable for interstate. So these are the two different classification which comes under GST. So now I'll tell you what is intrastate and interstate. So intrastate means within the state, that is if the transaction taking place within the state is called intrastate. Interstate means if the transaction taking place between two states, it's called interstate. So I'll tell you with an example. First, let me tell you what is intrastate. Intrastate means within the state, that is a transaction taking place in the same state, that is both the buyer and seller belongs to same state. In that case, it will be comes under intrastate. See, assume you're going to buy some goods and service from the supplier. You, that is the purchaser as well as seller, belongs to same state. Okay, this will be comes under intrastate. In this particular case, see, assume 10% GST. So this 10% GST will be split into two categories. The first one is central goods and service tax. The another one is state goods and service tax. Okay, so here the 10% will be split into two equal parts. 5% payable to central government. The remaining 5% will be payable to state government. The entire GST will be shared by central government as well as state government equally. Okay, in this case, that is in case of intrastate, the buyer has to pay 5% to central government and 5% to state government. So these are the two different GSTs applicable for intrastate. The next one is interstate. Interstate means between state. For example, if the transaction taking place between two different states, in that case, okay, it will be comes under interstate. So for interstate transaction, the buyer has to pay IGST, that is integrated goods and service tax. So this particular GST is applicable for interstate transaction. Assume you are a buyer, you belongs to Kerala. Okay, if you want to buy any goods and service from Andhra, the supplier belongs to Andhra. In this case, so for example, assume you are going to pay 10% integrated GST. Okay, here you need not pay CGST or SGST. Here you need to pay IGST. The entire 10% will be payable to Government of India. The Government of India will collect the total amount from you, that is from the buyer. And such tax shall be divided between the union and the states in the manner as may be provided by the parliament by law. Okay, so on the recommendation of the GST council. So based on the recommendation of GST council, the amount will be divided between union, that is the government, central government and state government. So here you need not split the amount. The total amount will be payable to Government of India and later they will share. The amount will be shared by the state government and central government. Okay, now we got the basic idea about GST. That is, in GST, we discuss about the three things. Central GST, state GST and integrated GST. Now let us see the accounting part of GST. Now let me tell you what are the different accounts has to be maintained by the trader. For all the organization, those are involving any goods and service transactions, they have to maintain, all the organization and traders has to maintain certain important accounts apart from their regular account. See here, there is a list. The trader has to maintain the following accounts apart from accounts like purchase account, purchase return account, sales account, sales return account, stock account, cash account, etc. So apart from the general transaction or general ledger account, they has to maintain these are the important ledgers. The first one is input central GST account. The next one output central GST account in the same way. And state government also, that is input SGST account and output SGST account. And the next one for integrated, input IGST account and output IGST account. For all three different GST, that is central GST and state GST, and the last one is integrated GST. For all three different GST, they has to maintain input as well as output. Okay, and the last one is electronic cash ledger. So this has to be maintained on government GST portal to pay GST. The final amount will be calculated based on the tabular column and the final amount will be payable to government through GST portal to pay GST. For that you have to maintain a separate ledger, is called electronic cash ledger. These are the necessary ledger has to be maintained by the organization, or any trader has to maintain this ledger account apart from the regular account. Okay, in the next video we are going to see all these accounts separately along with an example problem. That is, what is input CGST account, what is output CGST account, in the same way SGST and IGST, and the last one is electronic cash ledger account. These are the important accounts. No, so I am going to explain in the next video all these accounts separately along with an example problem. Hope you all understood this concept. Thank you.